Welcome back. Here I am in Omni's warehouse and Fortuitous. Omni just joined the game. Hello, Omni. Let's see, who else is here? Not Dragon. Dragon and Omni are here. So that's what Omni has been doing. He's built this beautiful big tree facade, and he built this automatic sorter, which makes all sorts of lovely things and puts them into the warehouse so they're all ready to use. Things like hardened glass and, yeah. And I've been working on this. And actually, I finished this the day before yesterday. Yeah. And this is what this great big building is for, is farms. My chocobos got pushed out there. Multi-block farms. See? We discovered a lot of the lag issue was due to the cables we were using, so now we are using RedNet cables. And the lag is much improved. I mean, it is running beautifully. I'm getting a good steady 20-30 frames, which is about normal for me. And I've turned a few of my settings back on, so I have water dripping again. And I can turn on the sun and the moon again. And so anyway, this runs off of a loop of biogoods to make biofuel, which goes into the generators, which burns the fuel to make electricity. That's shiny. Neat. So all the stuff comes in here and gets fed into the loop, and it goes into the system insertion pipe, where if there is room in the buffer, it will insert the item. Now, in the last game, I actually had a slow push in, and then they would, the items would return to their respective chests and flow out again in a fairly steady, slower tick. So I'm going to eventually replace this with that system. But for now, this was just to get this going, get some nice fuel, nice steady electricity supply. So that produces one of those feeds 8, which they each produce, you know, I'm terrible with the math and everything, but one of these reactors feeds 8 generators, so each of these, and I've still got biomatter down in the tube that it could be burning, but it's not. And I can stick my atomic disassembler in here, and it charges right up. And I can stick my blink drive in here, and it charges right up. And yeah, it works great. And let's see, what else have I done? I did quite a lot. I didn't want to record because my frame rate was so bad, it wouldn't have been a good video anyway. So that is an auto spawner for slimes. Whoops, and I fell in it. This is a grinder, which I should turn that back on soon because it's actually losing mob essence. But I need to find a way to store the mob essence in a better way so that I can auto-spawn a squid and grind it for ink sacs. Because the next building that I'm making requires a lot of ink sacs. These black bricks here are stone brick and ink sac, so I'm gonna need, and it's a great big, there's the other corner over there, so it'll be, go up like that, bunch of brick, black brick. It's beautiful brick, I love this, but it is a pain to make if you don't have squiddies. So this was a big mountain, and I'm taking that down so that I can put my, and in here will go animals. And then back here behind it is another farmhouse, greenhouse for farms. And back here are little eight little greenhouses in a row. One, two, three, and one, two, three. 6 or 8, I forget. Along the back of here, cute little greenhouses for things like the berry bushes. So, yeah. And the road goes around all of my area. So I'm still moving out to the east, flattening up that north part for the big animal shed. Making the road. But besides that, also been playing around down here in my house. Blink drive. It's amazing. So we discovered there are actually 2 or 3 levels beneath me. There's at least one above me, where the lovely blazes are. Oh yeah, I was playing with these essence plants, where instead of a squiddy, I can make... I also love this. You put these along here, and it makes 6 insects. Put it along here, makes cyan. There, it makes purple. I mean, these dyes are just amazing. I love these seeds. And the other one, where'd it go? There it is. The other ones are glowstone. So instead of hunting in the nether, we now have glowstone plants. So I'm probably going to make a whole big farm of these. Because heck with the nether. I don't want to go to the nether. I'm just going to farm my glowstone. So there. And this way we can have essence infused blocks. And yeah, glowstone essence blocks. They're very pretty. I don't know how to make them yet. This is how... Yes, you can make 12 glowstone just from 8 pieces of the essence. I'm not sure how to make the essence blocks. I'll figure that out. One step at a time, right? Right. But I'm working on the dye and the building. The black blocks. All of that. My kitties. My blaze neighbors are... noisy. Everything's so noisy. Yeah, it's nice and quiet up here. So, this goes back into the farm. This goes up. So yes, all the sheep are gonna get moved as soon as I finish the big black shed. All the animals are gonna get moved over there, and I'll have a sewer to collect sewage underneath them, and oh yeah, this is Dragon's nice little tree farm building, and I expanded the road out to his house. We both expanded the road out to his house, not quite finished yet. I'm not sure if he's going to take it out that way or what he's doing. He's got a little sheep friend. I can't see most of it because I'm on render distance tiny. So that the game runs. Because Big Dig is a very, very processor-intensive game. I mean, it's got 102 mods loaded. So, I mean, that is a lot for the computer to process. So, yeah, you're going to see a dip in performance, and you're going to have to adjust settings. And this is why I'm running Optifine. So I've changed all my video settings and my details. And I turned the sky and the moon and back on, and I turned back on water and lava and fire because they just look silly without it. And you know, it's not running too bad. I can handle 20-30 frames. I don't need to be going super fast. You know, this is not a gaming rig. This is a out of the box. It's got a 6 gig dual core processor. You know, 6 gig of RAM. But it doesn't have a video card, which is the biggest problem with this machine. It just doesn't have a video card. because when I bought it, I thought I could install my current video card into it, and that turned out to not work very well. So now I'm stuck with a computer without a video card, and I don't have the money to buy a video card. But, you know, silly me thinking I could save money by not buying an extra $100 computer with a video card, because I had one at home, and yeah. No returns, no exchanges. Yeah, somebody always does something to break something, and the poor Omni's gotta fix it. But he is wonderful. I don't even understand half of this. I'm just walking back and forth, kind of in awe, trying to think of where to start to explain this. I mean, stuff comes in here, and this one automatically makes smooth stone. I'm not sure what this one does. Marble cobblestone, so this would make marble. I mean, it's just, and this one would automatically make the salt, and it puts it back out into the system, and it goes back around, and so he filled on the last server. He filled all of this with these, I guess you call them commands. So it takes cobble, and it pulverizes it into sand? Sand. Wow. And this one takes sand and turns it into glass, so a certain amount of sand goes straight through, and a certain amount gets turned into glass, and it's just amazing, and so we have all of this automatically. And it's a great system, you know, because then we don't have to spend so much time crafting, we can just spend time building the other thing, building and working with this stuff. This is just the funnest part of Big Dig, is all the neat stuff. Hi, Omni. Yeah. Want some glowstone essence? Oh, he's busy working on the other server. So yeah, here is. The server is running great. We haven't had any crashes. No major problems, really. I've got a ton of bees waiting for me to have time to work on those, and I'm just so excited. So yeah, I need to get back to building, get some more squiddies. Ink sacks, sorry, squiddies. Ink sacks. And get that building up. I gotta finish taking down the mountain first. I love this thing. Boosh. Boosh. I love it. It's great. So I need to finish taking down this mountain. Yeah. Get this building up. Get the animals in here and get it all sorted. And it'll be marvelous. And then I can start working on the long farm and the other farms. And then I can do the bee stuff. Yay, bee stuff. Yay. Happy dimes. So I'll see you then. Oh, goodness gracious. What is all that? Why? I don't understand. I'm sorry about this. I don't know why it does this. If you have any idea why Fraps does this, I would really like a way to turn this off. So, I'm going to try to do this pretty quick. That's very distracting. So, last time I had all this farm done, but I have tweaked it a lot. I think it's been 2 days of tweaking. So it now all nice and steady. And instead of the chaotic loop, we have a nice slow insertion loop where each item comes back. And these are Arctic gates. When the pipe is empty, a single energy pulse is released. So it's not constantly spitting out items and constantly spinning items around. Yes, this is still a lot of items, but it's not ridiculous, and it's not fast, and it's not something I have to babysit and make sure that isn't spinning out of control. So each item has its own gate, has its own output. I can put more reactors along here, and they'll fill up. As you can see, I've got plenty of biomatter just from this reactor. Okay, so I will show this. Oh goodness, my inventory is full of dirt because I've been digging. Okay, so there's no fuel in here. So I'm going to move this. Boop. I will show you the difficulties. This is an insertion pipe if you don't play Big Dig. And so what a reactor does is, you can't see, the items come in here, and this is the item buffer, and this is the item processing. So right now it is eating this and making fuel. Nom nom nom, there go the items. Nom nom nom. So here's the buffer for the fuel and the biofuel, and the efficiency is how many different items. As you can see there, you can't fill this all with one item. It has to be different items. See. And I love how that just eats that now. Just get rid of that stuff. Alright, so we're going to be filling this buffer here pretty soon. And the items are just coming in here, just coming in here. Yeah. So one reactor will actually power or produce enough biofuel to constantly run 8 generators, I believe it is, at least. That was the math. Here you see the processing. So we have near perfect efficiency because a lot of different items in here. And that's what bumps up your efficiency. So I could do some oak saplings, and that would fill that last spot. Or what else? There are so many things that are biomatter that it's just crazy. Oh, my little march of items. My little march of items. And so this will all fill up, and then they'll start gathering in here. And this is the buffer. And then it'll look like this, where you have a stack. Yes. So there's farm. These are manual farms, which means you plant it. It does not replant for you, but it will take the harvested. Managed farms. It will plant. It will put out the dirt, or mycelium in that case, because it's mushrooms. So yeah, I like multi-block farms, even though they are big and bulky and difficult to handle. I like them better than the planter and harvester that Omni is using on his tree warehouse. That is good for all my cows. That is good for, you know, other things. Some of my chocobos as my frames are loading. This right here, this is under the big barn that I was making. Now I'll go up and show that. So this is, I will turn this on briefly. I can't turn it on for long. Orange is out. So now it has power. Get over here, get over here. Okay, the spawner in the middle there will spawn slimes. The grinder right there, whoops, right there, that little thing right there, will kill anything in front of it. Spit out this green goo called mob essence and the drops. And this I just started and I haven't run it barely at all, and I already have 5,000 slime balls. And this one I have on a switch. So I would have to go down here. And I've blocked this off because I'm silly. And it'll spawn squiddies. So I can get ink sacs, and then the ink sacs come through this phase pipe. And it also uses mob essence. You need mob essence to spawn them, and it makes mob essence. So once you get it started, it pretty much feeds itself. And you just shut it off by removing its power, and then the grinder will grind them down. That's why I have... That is the grinder, that is the spawner. like a light switch. So it will stop spawning when it runs out of energy, but then it'll continue killing. And those are my tanks of mob essence to spare. And when I need emergency mob essence, I'll just come over here and go, boop, empty. And it'll empty. And flow back into the pipes. And they'll go into the machines. Isn't that wonderful? It's just, poof. And I can get all the insects I need now. For building and for throwing in the bioreactor. And this is, of course, the rancher. Which shears sheep. So you automatically have sheep, and I've sorted all this, and that is wonderful. And that was a lot of work. Pipes and electricity are probably the most tedious part of Big Dig. Building and all these wonderful other materials is just, it's amazing, and I love it. Ugh. Okay. Oh, doors. Doors hate me. Okay, so here's all the sheep. And that's probably quite a number of sheep for the amount of grass in there. But it's bigger than my chocobo pen. And I've only begun to breed chocobos. So over here we've got some piggies. And as you heard, the cows. And a great big red blob over my head. I'm not sure why. This is ghostwood planks, and I love this look. Looks like corrugated metal to me. So yeah, that's my animal shed, and I've finished top of the greenhouse. And please, if you know why I'm getting these, I assume the lines are chunk markers because they look to be about 16 blocks apart. And they look to be square. Alright, so then there's these little greenhouses back here that I built last night. And I'm probably going to build one more over in this area. So that I can then put another greenhouse over here. And I think what I'm going to put in here are magical essence plants because I'm really getting into that. Well, what I did on the last server was trees and pumpkins, things like that. But this time, not feeling it. And I really want to get into the magical essence plants. Maybe you're in the wrong building. So you can watch. Okay, this is still going. And for some reason, this farm gave me trouble. It's actually sensitive to light, and it's not that I recall supposed to be, and it's my computer trying to process. So what I'm going to put in here are probably the berry bushes, maybe things like raspberries and corn, and, you know, the silly little plants. Probably cotton. I'll have some dirt in there. Yeah, that's been fun. And that's why I've been digging. Flattening out that area for that other greenhouse. And then once I get that greenhouse, the size of it plotted out, and then I can probably... It's gotten dark, so I really shouldn't be out here. But then I can come over here, and I can't put bees in a jungle. So my bee house has to be at least over here in the forest. But that starts right here. So, and the river counts as a temperate zone. I just have to watch where I put my bee house. So I've got all this right here. And that should be, one more of those little greenhouses. And then a road, or, you know, a sidewalk. And, hello zombie, no killing me, no pushing me into a quarry this time, I'm sorry. Sorry, I've got all this on my screen, it's quite a mess. And I don't usually get that great big red. That's just bothering me. So anyway, that's what I've been doing. Why? Because the piggy's standing on the pressure plate. Omni has been busy doing all sorts of things. But, you know, tweaking out the bugs. He's gotten a lot of things working. So Dragon did this nice building, and this lovely building, which I believe does mob things as well. Yes, it's a grinder and a spawner, so that's fun. So while I'm doing it just to power my bioreactor, I don't know. He's probably doing it for drops, I assume. He made this gorgeous little fountain. Boop. Time for a bath. So excuse me while I have my bath. And thank you for watching. And I hope, you know, come play with us. Because Big Gig is awesome. And, you know, even if you have a crappy computer like mine, it's running pretty good. I'm not great. 16, 15 FPS. But that's with all these machines around. If I go out into the wilderness, I get like 160 and it's fine. It's just all these moving parts and all of this automation does make a drain on your computer. So, yeah, I mean, and it's not really that bad. Not anymore. Because we've found the things that cause the most lag and we're like, ah, nope, we don't need those. And we fixed quite a number of issues, so. Yeah, come play. It's Big Dig is an amazing. There's chocobos, there's bees, there's tree breeding. You can breed trees. Isn't that amazing? It's hilarious. And they got all these different kind of blocks. And yeah, come play. Come on, hon. We need some more people on the server. This is too awesome. We need some more people here. And you can play with all these different machines. I mean, there's 102 mods. 102 all in one, and they don't all work perfectly together, but they all work pretty good together. And Big Dig is absolutely my favorite mod pack ever. I mean, there's just no comparison how much I love it. I love Big Dig more than I love Skyblock, more than I love Agrarian Skies, more than I love Captive Minecraft. I'm sorry. I love it. I love Big Dig. And you're going to see a lot more of these, and hopefully... Please tell me how to get rid of this. Please. Because I can't stand this. I really can't. I'm not sure if that's in my Minecraft settings or my prep settings, but I've been looking all over the place and I can't find what will fix that. Please tell me what it is. It's only in Big Dig. It doesn't do it in any other game or browser or program. It's just Big Dig. So I don't know if it's just some conflict. Big Dig people, help. Send help. Okay, I've gone too long now. I'm sorry. Hope to see you soon. Bye.